In one of my previous videos I show you how I create my famous Holy Planet photos on my smartphone. This time I give you further tips how to retouch your images like a pro without transferring them to your computer. Watching a 360 channel obviously will see me working with 360 photos, but I hope this episode will be useful to anyone who wants to create better photos with a smartphone. You know, talking about 360 images or normal photos, Snapseed is a very useful app to make small corrections. I usually use the healing tool, which works like a spot healing brush in Photoshop. But one of its disadvantages is that you can't control how the algorithm will affect your image, and it doesn't work so nice with complicated patterns. But now I show you another free app called Photoshop Mix, which can be very useful if you have an idea of what you want. Talking about 360 photos, one of the biggest problems is that sometimes we appear on the image whether we want it or not. If you are interested about my techniques how to behave in front of a 360 camera to get a great result, check out my video on the right top corner. But now let's talk about a situation when we want a clean photo without people on it, and we don't have a tripod and a remote controller. In these cases, we get photos like this. Without me, it would be a great little planet and inverted planet too, but this way it doesn't look so nice, so let's try to fix it. First, I start with the inverted planet. As you can see, I'm standing on the bridge and it ruins the whole image. I stand next to the railing, so a simple tool like a healing brush wouldn't solve the problem. There are too many details and textures there. And the algorithm should generate the pattern of the railing and the floor too. But with Photoshop Mix we can work with multiply layers and masks, so I have an idea. I open the image in Photoshop Mix and instead of working with different images, I open the same image twice as separate layers. So I have the same image on the top of each other. It's a totally symmetrical photo just like most of the tiny planet or inverted planet photos. And I have the issue with the right top corner, so first I flip the background layer, and this way that corner will be okay there. Of course now we only see that there are two layers and the bottom layer is flipped. But now I select the upper layer and start editing. I tap on cut out function and using the smart selection tool I switch to subtract. Then tapping on myself in the corner I see the changes. Actually the bottom layer appears as I erase this one. Clicking on the layer icon on the top I can switch between views. With the multi-layer view I see the layers underneath, and with the single layer view I see this layer with a transparent background. This time I prefer the multi-layer view, because that's how I see my correction perfectly. To hide that sharp stitching line, I tap on refine function so I can feather the edges. Then I make the mask more accurate. So instead of generating random pixels with an application, I use existing image pixels, so it will look natural and perfect. Besides smart selection tool, we can work with a basic brush. I can switch between the eraser and the brush tool to find the mask. When I find it okay, I tap on the check mark. Now I see the retouched image, and on the right column I see both layers. I also see how I erase the upper layer. Hiding the bottom image, I can check out the affected parts much better. And turning the background visible, I actually like the result, so I save and export the photo. It's another advantage of Photoshop Mix that the whole editing process is totally non-destructive. Your original files remain untouched on your phone, while you can create many different copies with different settings. And in another example I will show you how to edit the same photo as a little planet. This time I also import the same image twice and select the upper layer. I tap on cutout function and select the eraser with the basic function on the bottom. And I slowly start to erase myself from the image. I can refine the erased parts switching between the eraser and the brush tool. When I find it okay, I tap on the check mark. First it seems like nothing changed. But looking at the top layer you can see it has a transparent area. Switching to the background layer and modifying it, it becomes obvious that actually the upper layer is transparent. Finalizing this correction is not so easy like in the previous case, because I have to move and rotate the bottom layer to position it perfectly. Then I switch back to the top layer and refine the mask. So you can see how we can use Photoshop Mix to hide people and objects on a 360 photo. It's also a great method to hide a tripod too, where Snapseed or other healing brush tools don't do a proper job. Of course we can mix different images just like this. In this case we can create really creative photos with the very same app and process. I hope you like this method, and if you do, please thumbs up. And if you are interested about further 360 shooting and editing techniques, subscribe to my YouTube channel and check out this playlist on the right top corner. See you soon, guys!